فؤادك الأيام فتى.
لأن فعلهم أكذب قولهم.
Because their action disbelieves in their speech. Their action does disbelieve of their speech. They say something with your tongue, but when you look at the actions, the action is on a different channel.
فإن قلت هم جاهلون أنهم مشركون بما يفعلون.
فإن قلت if you say هم جاهلون, they are ignorant that they are polytheists, مشركون بما يفعلون, that which they do. قلت
قد صرح الفقهاء في كتب الفقه في باب الردة أن من تكلم بكلمة الكفر يكفر.
Ha. So Amir al-Sanani said, the fuqaha, they mentioned in their books of fiqh, in Bab al-Ridda, the books of apostation, that أن من تكلم بكلمة الكفر, that the person who speaks a speech of kufr, ha, he becomes a kafir. Hayya.
وإن لم يقصد معناها,
even if he didn't intend its meaning, he will still become a kafir. Now pay attention. Sheikh Abdul Muhsin al-Abbad, حفظه الله, he pointed out this point. He said, هذا الكلام الذي ذكره الإمام الصنعاني ليس على إطلاقه. That which الإمام الأمير الصنعاني mentioned there is not unrestricted. Just like that. قد يحصل مثل ذلك عن إكراه. Sometimes a person can say كلمة كفر. But he's under duress. He's been forced to say it. And he doesn't intend the meaning. It could be, or it can be sabqi lisanin, Sheikh said. Or it can be a slip of the tongue. بدون قصد لل, maybe out of excessive happiness. He didn't intend the word. And he said it. Like the man who said it. Who had his riding beast. Who lost his riding beast. الذي وجد ناقته بعد أن يئس. Minha, like the man who gave up on his riding beast. He thought he lost it, so he got ready for death. And then when he looked up, he found his riding beast on top of him. And he said, Allahumma anta abdi, oh Allah, you are my slave. Wa ana rabbuka, I am your Lord. The Prophet said, akhta'a min shiddati al-farah. He got it wrong out of what? Out of excessive happiness. So did he intend to say that statement? So that is not at its... But there's an issue that has to be understood here. What we have to understand, which is a mas'ala that falls into irja. Which is, some people say, in order for you to become a kafir, you have to intend the kufr. Pay attention. Nope. You don't have to intend the kufr. You can become a kafir without intending to become a kafir. Are you with me? What did Allah say? يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَرْفَعُوا أَصْوَاتَكُمْ فَوْقَ صَوْتِ النَّبِيِّ وَلَا تَجْهَرُوا لَهُ بِالْقَوْلِ كَجَهْرِ بَعْضِكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ أَنْ تَحْبَطَ أَعْمَالُكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ. So a person can become a kafir, even that though he didn't intend a kufr. That's not a condition for you to know that this is a kufr akbar. It's not a condition for you to become a kafir. But what you have to intend is the action. Pay attention. قصد الفعل is a condition for us to make you a kafir. لكن قصد المعنى. قصد الحكم. That you intend the rule, the ruling. Are you with me? We don't care about that. Doesn't matter. As long as you intended the action, that's what matters. If you intended the kufr from it, it doesn't change anything. Like for example, a person takes the mushaf, and he stands on the mushaf. And when he stands on the mushaf, he says, I didn't do it out of kufr. It doesn't matter. I only done it because I was joking. I want to show my friends I can do it. Kafir. Billahi al-Aliyyul Azim. Our question is, did you get the mushaf and put it down and stand on it? Yes. And the hadith is the same. The man who came to the Prophet, قُلَ بِاللَّهِ وَآيَاتِ وَرَسُولِي كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَهْزِئُونَ لَا تَعْتَذِرُوا قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ. What were they saying? كُنَّا نَخُوذُ وَنَلْعَبْ. We were only joking when we said those statements that we were saying. Are you with me? We were joking. We didn't mean the kufr. Ya Rasulullah, we didn't mean it. We only meant to joke. Our intention was the joking, not that kufr. The Prophet says, Allah said in the Quran, لا تعتذروا, don't look for excuses. قد كفرتم بعد إيمانكم. As long as the person intends the action, that's enough. But to say that the person has to intend the hukum, that's irja. That's aqidatul murji'ah, not aqidah ahli sunnah. Naam.
وهذا دل على
وهذا دال
وهذا دال على أنهم لم يعرفوا حقيقة الإسلام.
And that is evidence to show what? That these people haven't understood the reality of Islam. So the Sheikh is right in the statement, which is even though they do shirk kufr akbar, they're kufar. They are kufar. نعم. If they were Muslims, they came into Islam, then they become murtadin. So they're not Muslims. With the condition, of course, they're in a land where Tawheed, and a lot of these people are, they're in Muslim lands. The Masajid Tawheed have been called to, and they are worshipping shrines of kuffar. They are what? Kuffar. Now, even that though, they believe in their heart that what they are doing is what? It's Tawheed. Would that suffice them? The Mushrikeen thought they were doing the same. If you go to a Christian today and you ask him, are you a monotheist individual? He'll say yes. He believes he's a muwahid. The Christian believes he's a muwahid. The Jew believes he's a they believe their religion is what? It is a religion which is harmoniousism religion. Mushrikeen they are. Naam.
وَلَا مَا هِيَّةَ التَّوْحِيدِ
So these people, the Sheikh said, they don't know the reality of Islam. And wallahi asaba wa afad. The Sheikh was a nasih al ameen. Sincere advisor. Naam, they didn't understand the haqiqat of Islam. ولا ماهية التوحيد. ماهية means what? ماهية they didn't understand. ماهية الشيء is the essence of this thing. They didn't understand the essence of توحيد. That's what ماهية means.
فصاروا حينئذ كفارا كفرا كفرا أصليا.
They're كفار. Their ignorance here is not accepted. They are كفار كفرا أصليا the Sheikh says.
فإن الله تعالى قد فرض على عباده إفراده بالعبادة.
Because Allah made obligatory upon His servants to single Him in what? In worship. He said,
ألا تعبدوا إلا الله.
Not to worship except Allah.
وإخلاصها له.
And to sing and sincerity with Allah in it.
وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ
وَمَا أُمِرُوا They were not ordered إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ Except to worship Allah مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ Sincerity in their religion
وَمَنَّادَ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى لَيْلًا وَنَهَارًا وَسِرًّا وَجِهَارًا وَخَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا
Anyone who calls unto Allah at night daytime and nighttime. He calls unto Allah privately and publicly. He calls unto Allah with hope and fear.
ثُمَّ نَادَى مَعَهُ غَيْرَهُ
And then he calls unto other than Allah. He's asking Allah as well and other than Allah.
فَقَدْ أَشْرَكَ فِي الْعِبَادَةِ
He has fallen into shirk in his ibadah.
فَإِنَّ الدُّعَاءَ مِنَ الْعِبَادَةِ وَقَدَ سَمَّاهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عِبَادَةً فِي قَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى
الدُّعَاء is a ibadah and Allah called the dua a ibadah. Allah called it. Pay attention. Look how he brings the evidence out of this.
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي
Underline the word عِبَادَتِي. هيه.
سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِرِينَ
When was this? After what ayah? The beginning of the ayah is Udu'uni astajib lakum Inna la That's how the ayah is. After Allah said Udu'uni call unto me Astajib lakum I will obey and accept your supplication. I will accept it. Inna alladhina verily those Yastakbiruna who are arrogant An ibadati my worshipping. What worshipping is he referring to here? Who's arrogant of the supplication, that's what he's referring to. Because that was the أَقْرَبُ الْمَذْكُورِ That was the last mentioned thing. So the dua, Allah referred to it as what? As a ibadah. Also, Allah also referred to the dua as a deen. Allah referred to the dua as the religion, the deen. قَالَ تَعَالَى What did Allah say? وَدُعُوهُ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ وَدُعُوهُ Call unto him. Insincerity in this deen. So dua is the deen. Naam. And we took before that the dua is two types. The whole religion doesn't come out of dua. As a slave, you can't go out of dua. One is called dua ibadah and another is called dua mas'ala. Dua mas'ala is when you say, Ya Allah, this is the dua. This is the one that people know the most. It's called dua mas'ala. Allahumma ghafirli. Allahumma arhamni. Allahumma innaka afuun kareem tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anni. That's called dua. Dua mas'ala. Dua ibadah means what? Your fasting is a dua. Why are you fasting for? Are you asking Allah for Jannah by fasting? It's a dua. Your salah, what is it? Why are you praying for? Why are you standing up at Fajr? Going to the salah. Allah, why you saying Allahu Akbar when everybody else is sleeping? You're asking for Jannah, right? And then, ooh, that's a dua as well. Called what? Dua, ibadah. All of them are ibadah. صرفها لغير الله شرك. نعم. The dua ul mas'ala lakin, you are allowed to ask something for somebody. With the condition that they are hayyun. Hayyun. Hadirun. Qadirun. Three of those. He's alive, he's present, and he's able. If you ask him, then I said, no shirk. I can give me that cup. He's alive. He's there with you at that point. And he's also what? He's able to get the cup. He's what? He's able to get the cup. If you tell a six-week child, get me that cup, and you believe he can get that cup, shirkun billahi al-ali al-azim. Huh? He's not able to do it. Do you think he's ilah? He has supernatural powers. Na'am. You come to a person and you say to him, Akhi, can you send rain down for us? It's really getting hot nowadays. We haven't seen rain for a long, long time. The person is hayyun. Hadirun. But is he qadir? Then mas'ala has to have those three conditions met. When it's met, yajuz. If those one of them is absent, a person is alive, he's able to do it. He's alive. He's able to do it. But he's not with you. You're not communicating with him. So what do? Here I'm saying, Akhi, Abdul Jalil. Akhi, please bring me my car. Abdul Jalil, bring me my car. شرك هي.
فإن قلت فإذا كانوا مشركين وجب جهادهم والسلوك فيهم ما سلك رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في المشركين.
Say that again.
فإن قلت
If you say
فإذا كانوا مشركين وجب جهادهم والسلوك فيهم ما سلك رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في المشركين.
He said, فإن قلت if you say to me now that these people are exactly like the mushrikeen and they are all the same and everything, then it would mean if they are mushriks, these people, the grave worshippers, then it becomes obligatory to fight with them. وَالسُّلُوكِ فِي مَا سَلَكَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ And to take the path that the Prophet took with the grave worshippers. Hey? قُلْتُ I'll say.
قُلْتُ إِلَى هَذَا ذَهَبَ طَائِفَةٌ مِّنْ أَئِمَّةِ الْعِلْمِ فَقَالُوا يَجِبُ أَوَّلًا دُعَاؤُهُمْ إِلَى التَّوْحِيدِ
Sheikh's point here, he said, إِلَى هَذَا ذَهَبَ طَائِفَةٌ مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ It's not a right word. It's not right. But he says, this view, a group of scholars, people of scholars took this. It looks like he's trying to say that there are other groups from the أئمة العلم who don't see this view. And this is what? Opposite to the reality, truth. This issue is what? Is a mas'alatu nususu al-wahyi la mas'alata khilaf. This is a text. No ulama opposes that these individuals, this is how they should be dealt with. Which he's going to mention it, but when he mentioned it as though it's a belief of some group of the scholars. إلى هذا ذهب طائفة من أهل العلم. Nah. It's a mas'alatu nususu al-wahyi. Mansusu al-wahyi. It's a mas'ala which the text, the evidence of the text in the Kitab and the Sunnah have come regarding, is not masail al-khilaf. And I want you to all realize something here right now. People always get it wrong. There's a difference between mas'alat ijtihadiyya and a mas'alatun khilafiyya. There's two different things. People mix them all the time together. If the scholars say this is mas'ala ijtihadiyya and this is a mas'ala which is khilafiyya. If the mas'ala is mas'alatun ijtihadiyya, you see, if there's an ijtihad, then the qa'ida is la inkara fil ijtihad. If the matter is ijtihad, then there's no rights that you can reject. Meaning, what do I mean by reject? You can't rebuke anybody for holding that view. Because the mas'ala is ijtihad. Like, if the mas'ala is khilafiyya, some people say, akhi, this mas'ala khilafiyya, no problem. Let's just agree to disagree. So music is allowed. Mas'ala khilafiyya. وَهَلْ كُلُّ خِلَافٍ مُعْتَبَرٍ Is every khilaf taken into consideration? لا. Some khilaf yunkar is rejected. So what's the difference between the two? Ijtihad means, mas'ala ijtihadiyya means a mas'ala that there is no text with it. Every alim is standing over one text and he's bringing an understanding out of it. One is saying this and one is saying that. And both of them don't have an external text to back them up in that which they are saying. So their understanding, both of them are present in this hadith. Is mas'ala ijtihadiyya. Whichever one seems to you to correct, no problem. La bas. Does that make sense? What's that called? Ijtihadiyya, this is called. Mas'ala khilafiyya means a person has the dalil with him. He holds onto a dalil. The other alim never saw this dalil before. He said something else. Are you with me? At this point, we'll take the one that's got the dalil in this issue. Are you with me? We'll take the one that has the dalil in this issue. Na'am.
فَقَالُوا يَجِبُ أَوَّلًا دُعَاؤُهُمْ إِلَى التَّوْحِيدِ
So the obligation of these people who are grave worshippers, how do you deal with them? The Shaykh said, يَجِبُ It is wajib. Firstly, to call them to Tawheed. إخواني, it is the job of the du'at to educate the people on Tawheed. We have to call these people to Tawheed. Bring them back to the understanding of Tawheed. Hey?
وَإِبَانَةُ أَنَّ مَا يَعْتَقِدُونَهُ يَنْفَعُ وَيَضُرُّ
And we have to clarify. Let whoever wants to love us, love us. Let whoever wants to hate us, hate us. It's up to them. We don't care. But for us is إِبَانَة. إِبَانَة means what? It is to unveil, clarify. It is to prove that which they are believing أَنَّ مَا يَعْتَقِدُونَهُ يَنْفَعُ وَيَضُرُّ To clarify what? That which they believe, it benefits and it harms.
لا يغني عنهم من الله شيئا.
That it will not suffice them besides Allah anything. This which they believe, it will not help them. It will not suffice them. Hey?
وأنهم أمثالهم.
And that they are like them.
وأن هذا الاعتقاد منهم فيهم. شرك لا يتم الإيمان بما جاءت به الرسل إلا بتركه والتوبة منه.
The Sheikh said, رحمه الله تعالى, he said what? That وأن هذا الاعتقاد منهم فيهم. And this اعتقاد, this belief that is present in them that they have is what? شرك. It's shirk. لا يتم الإيمان إلا بما جاءت به الرسل إلا بتركه والتوبة منه. And that their iman is what? It will not be established unless they come and stick to that which the messengers have been given. To leave off the shirk, to repent from it. Hayya.
وَإِفْرَادِ التَّوْحِيدِ اعْتِقَادًا وَعَمَلًا اللَّهِ تَعَالَى وَحْدَهُ
اعْتِقَادًا وَعَمَلًا لِلَّهِ وَحْدَهُ To believe in terms of, in their hearts, and in terms of their actions, that Tawheed is for Allah alone. Good. نعم.
وهذا واجب على العلماء.
This is obligatory on the scholars.
أي بيان أن ذلك الاعتقاد الذي تفرعت عنه النذور والنحائر والطواف بالقبور.
You have to clarify what? This belief, which has so much things came under it, which is what? Oaths and vows that are made, slaughtering, dawaf around the graves, all of them, that they are shirkun muharram, that it's shirk and that it's haram. The ulama, it's their job to prove this. They have to do this. It's a job that the title they have to take on. Hayya.
وَأَنَّهُ عَيْنُ مَا كَانَ يَفْعَلُهُ الْمُشْرِكُونَ لِأَصْنَامِهِمْ
And that they clarify to these grave worshippers that what they are doing is exactly what the polytheists used to do for their idols. Exactly. You guys are the same, right?
فَإِذَا أَبَانَ الْعُلَمَاءُ ذَٰلِكَ لِلْأَئِمَّةِ وَالْمُلُوكِ
If the ulama, they clarify that to the imams And they clarify that to who? The muluk, the leaders, and the people of authority.
وَجَبَ عَلَى الْأَئِمَّةِ وَالْمُلُوكِ بَعْثُ دُعَاءٍ إِلَىٰ إِخْلَاصِ التَّوْحِيدِ
The rulers then should take the responsibility of what? To send out callers دُعَاتٍ إِلَىٰ النَّاسِ يَدْعُونَهُمْ إِلَىٰ إِخْلَاصِ التَّوْحِيدِ لِلَّهِ Calling the people towards to tawheed, to single Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in worship. They are du'at, they have to send those du'ats that do that. The du'at ain't talking about qisas and stories and here and that. He's calling them to tawheed. The issue which the ummah are died, where their cancer lies. People are talking to people about stories, qisas. Where here? Which no one's going to ever go against you. The grave worshipper, the person of the sunnah, all of them are listening to you. MashaAllah. 1 hour lecture and they benefited, they found a good story and they went. Like in the minute you touch on Tawheed, you see the a'da of Islam. The enemies of Islam start coming out. They get angry and upset. So that's where the illness lies. Na'am.
فَمَنْ رَجَعَ وَأَقَرَّ
Anyone who comes back from it, where he was upon, and he affirms.
حُقِنَ عَلَيْهِ دَمُهُ وَمَالُهُ وَذَرَارِيَّ
Anyone who comes back when so Sheikh said, who's going to do this? It's a Muslim leader. He sends du'at. Those du'at go out. They convey the tawheed. They call the people to the sunnah. They call the people to leave of shirk. When the hujjah is established on the people and they have been told this is shirk, if they come back, good. And if not, if they come back, what happens? It's good. Good why? حُقِنَ عَلَيْهِ دَمُهُ His blood is saved for him. وَمَالُهُ His wealth. وَذَرَارِيهِ ذَرَارِيهِ is his families, his wives and his children. They will not be touched. If he doesn't like him, come back to he's dealt with as a mushrik kafir. His blood is spilt. He's fought with as a disbeliever. His money becomes permissible. His women are taken as a captive. نعم.
وَمَنْ أَصَرَّ فَقَدْ أَبَاحَ اللَّهُ مِنْهُ مَا أَبَاحَ لِرَسُولِهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ
The Sheikh says, فَقَدْ أَبَاحَ اللَّهُ مِنْهُ Allah has made mubah from them مَا أَبَاحَ لِرَسُولِهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ That which Allah made permissible from the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم the pagans. What is permissible from them is exactly what the Prophet ﷺ was given permissible over the pagans. Here, inshallah ta'ala, is a mas'ala which is very important, which is mas'ala tul udhri bil jahl.